टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्रेडिटेशन एनबीए फॉर द बिजनेस स्कूल. ही हैज पार्टिसिपेटेड इन द मेन इंस्टीट्यूशंस फॉर द एक्रेडिटेशन प्रोसेस एंड व्हाट इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ द एक्रेडिटेशन. दिस विल बी डिस्कस्ड टुडे हियर. And this is the accreditation manual for the business school. The National Board of the Accreditation Office is the NBCC Place, East Tower, 4th floor, this Pitama Marg, Pragati Bihar, New Delhi 3. This is the accreditation office of the manual for the business school. From the chairman, NBA committee on the business accreditation on the evaluation, on behalf of the distinguished member of the NBA committee of the management. The chairman is the Binay Sil Gautam. The contents of the accreditation manual are the introduction to the National Board of the Accreditation, introduction, authority of the NBA, accreditation, accreditation policy, Section 2, the accreditation process and the requisites, organization, mission, governance and leadership, input processes, enablers, processing, processes, outcome, results. Section 3, self-assessment guide, the purpose of the self-assessment process, the self-assessment report. Self-assessment is the major important thing in the National Board of the Accreditation, guide to the preparation of the self-assessment report. Section 4, peer review guide, the peer review process, award of the accreditation, summary of the peer review process, few important points for the expert committee visit, the expert committee report. Benefits of the accreditation is given in the section 5. What are the benefits of the accreditations are there? Section 6, Annexure 1, program summary. Annexure 2, institutional summary. Annexure 3, business school evaluation sheet. Annexure 4, criteria satisfaction checklist. Criteria satisfaction checklist. Section 1, introduction to the National Board of the Accreditation. Education plays a vital role in the development of the any nation. Therefore, there is a premium on the both quality, quantity and quality, relevance and excellence of the academic programs offered of the higher education. Like in any other domain, the method to improve quality remains the same. That is, finding and recognizing new needs and satisfying them with products and services of the international standard. There are two central bodies involved in the accreditation. The National Accreditation and Assessment Council, NAC, National Accreditation and the Assessment Council, NAC, and the National Board of the Accreditation, NBA. The NAC was set up in the 1994 by the University Grant Commission for the Institutional Accreditation through a combination of the internal and external quality assessment. NBA was originally constituted in the September 1994 to assess the qualitative competence of the educational institution from the diploma level to the postgraduate level in engineering and technology, management, pharmacy, architecture, and the related discipline. The NBA in its present form has come into existence as an autonomous body with the effect from the 7th January 2010. With the objective of the assurance of the quality and relevance of the technical education through the mechanism of the accreditation of the program offered by the technical institution. The NBA works very closely with the stakeholder, faculty, educational institution, government, industry, regulators, management, student, recruiters, alumni, and their parents to ensure that the program serves to prepare their graduates with sound knowledge of the fundamentals and to develop in them an adequate level of the professional competence, such as would meet the needs of the engineering profession locally as well as the globally. The objective of the NBA is to assess and accredit institution as well as professional program offered at the various levels by the technical schools on the basis of the norm prescribed by the NBA. In this manual, the phrase business school, B school, means colleges, university, department offering master level program, management program, MBA and the PGD. The vision of the NBA is to be an accrediting agency of the international report by the ensuring the highest degree of credibility in assurance of the quality and relevance of the professional education and fulfill the expectation of its stakeholders, academicians, corporate, educational institution, government, industry, regulators, students, and their parents. The NBA is working with the mission to stimulate the quality of teaching, self-evaluation, accountability in higher education system, which help institutions realize their academic objective and adopt teaching practices and enable them to produce high-quality professionals and to assess and credit the programs offered by the colleges or the institution or both imparting technical education and the professional education. The main objectives of the NBA are assess and grade colleges and or institution of the technical professional education, the courses and programs offered by them, their various units, faculty, department, etc. Stimulate the academic environment and quality of teaching and research in this institution. Contribute to the sphere of the knowledge in its discipline. Motivate knowledge and or institution of the technical professional education of research and adopt teaching practices that groom their student for the innovation and development of the leadership quality. Development of the leadership quality is essential in case of the education. Encourage innovation, self-evaluation and accountability in the higher education. Promote necessary changes, innovation, and reforms in all aspects of the working of the colleges, institution of the technical professional education for the above purpose and help institution to realize their academic objectives. Authorities of the NBA. At present, the NBA has the following authority: the General Council, the Executive Committee, the President. The General Council is the principal authority of the NBA and is responsible for its overall activity and affairs. It gives policy, directions, guidelines to the Executive Committee that takes steps for managing the activity and affairs of the NBA accordingly. The General Council consists of the following members: Chairperson of the AICTA, President, Ex Officio, Secretary of the Department dealing with the higher or technical education, Government of India, or his nominee, ex officio. Chairperson of the statutory authority established by the Parliament for coordinating, determining the and regulating the standards of the higher and technical professional education in their respective field of his or her nominee. The President of the Association of the Indian University, or his or her nominee. 5 members of the Executive Committee nominated by the Executive Committee. 4 Vice Chancellor, 2 from the state university, 1 is from the central university, and essentially having the faculty in the technical or professional education and institute declared as deemed to be the university, essentially having faculty in technical or professional education to be nominated by the chairperson, AICT. 6 principal of the affiliated autonomous college, including polytechnics, 1 is from the discipline of the engineering, technology, architecture, town planning, management, pharmacy, and applied arts and craft to be nominated by the chairperson, AICT. Member secretary of the NBA is the member secretary of the General Council. The term nominated members is 3 years. Executive Committee. The affairs of the NBA are managed, administered, directed, and controlled as per rules and bylaws approved by the Executive Committee. The General Council and the chairman of the AICTA, the Executive Committee of the NBA for the purpose of the Society Registration Act consists of the following members. Chairperson appointed as person as per the procedure given under the rules 37 and 38 of the Memorandum of the Association and the rules of the NBA. Vice Chairperson of the All India Council for the Technical Education, ex officio. Additional Secretary, Joint Secretary, MHRD, Department of Education, dealing with the technical education of his or her nominee, ex officio. Secretary of the statutory regulatory body or for higher technical and professional education like other specialty council, UGC, AICTA, NCT, Council for the Architecture and Council for the Pharmacy, etc., ex officio. 4 Secretary of the higher and technical education of the state government nominated by the President, ex officio. 4 Academician and 2 experts from the industry nominated by the President, ex officio. two experts from the academia or industry nominated by the central government ex officio. The acuity committee may opt maximum two experts in the field of the accreditation from the India and abroad ex officio. Member secretary of the general council of the NBA is the member secretary of the acuity committee. NBA committee for the accreditation, evaluation and accreditation committee. The EC is constituted for each discipline, engineering, technology, management, pharmacy, architecture, to review the evaluation team's report and submits its recommendation on the accreditation to the EC. The composition of the EC is as follows. The chairman of the EAC, appointed by the EAC, is an eminent academician from the academia or a distinguished professional from the industry, R&D organization, professional body, etc. Three experts from the respective discipline with different specialization. One expert from industry, R&D organization. One representative from the professional body. One representative of the NBA nominated by the member secretary of the NBA. Appellate committee. The grievance and the redressal of the institution received by the NBA on the accreditation of the program shall be addressed by the appeal committee. The composition of the appeal committee is as follows. The chairman of the appellate committee, appointment by the EC, shall be an eminent academician from academia or a distinguished professional from the industry, R&D organization, professional body. One expert, preferably from the engineering, from the academia. One representative from industry, R&D organization. One representative from the professional body. One legal representative, even nominated by the member secretary of the NBA. Accreditation is a process of the quality assurance and improvement where an institute or a program offered by an institution is critically appraised to verify that the institution or the program constitutes to meet the exceed the norms and standards prescribed by the appropriate designated authority. Accreditation does not seek to replace the system of award of the degree and diploma by the university institution, but accreditation provides quality assurance that the academic aims and objectives of the institution are honestly pursued and effectively achieved by the resources available, and that the institution has demonstrated a capability of ensuring effectiveness of the educational programs over the validity of the period of the accreditation. The NBA accreditation is quality assurance scheme for the higher technical education. Significance of the accreditation: to make the institute department aware of the weakness of the program offered by it and act on suggestion for the improvement. To encourage the institute to move continuously towards the improvement of quality of its program and the pursuit of the excellence. To facilitate institution for updating themselves in program curriculum, teaching learning process, faculty achievement, student skill, ability, and the knowledge. To excel among the stakeholders, peers, students, employer, and the society. To facilitate receiving of grants from the government regulatory body and the institution and agency. To attain international recognition of the accredited degree awarded. To facilitate the mobility of the graduated student and the professionals. Accreditation policy. The following general policy are the guiding principle for the accreditation of the business school. Educational institutions are accredited at present. Business school to be accredited should be those which have been formally approved by the appropriate designated authority or the authority or the authority as the case may be. Business school which have produced postgraduate for at least the two academic years will be considered for the full accreditation and provisional accreditation as the case may be. Business school will be considered for the assessment and accreditation only at the written request of the educational institution and after agreeing to abide the NBA accreditation manual, rules, regulation, and notification issued from time to time. Accreditation will normally be granted for a specific term of up to a maximum of the 5 academic years. Provisional accreditation may be also be granted to the new business school not matured for the full accreditation. After accreditation, the institutions are expected to submit their annual self-assessment report to the ENBA line. If any aspect of the program is found to be sufficiently unsatisfactory and does not comply with the norms, the NBA reserves the right to revoke the accreditation. If necessary, the NBA may appoint a maximum of the 2 members to form an evaluation team to act as a mentor at the request of the institution. The mentor may visit the educational institution as its request for mentoring purposes and provide a report to the NBA on their finding for each visit. The educational institution will bear at the expenses for the visit and pay harmonium to the mentors as described by the NBA. Accreditation is based on satisfying the minimum standard. All cross funders between the educational institution and the NBA BCBS accreditation process is confidential and may not be revealed to any unauthorized person under any circumstances, except with written permission from a concerned educational institution. A 3-day on-site visit shall be part of the accreditation process. An evaluation team appointed by the NBA will carry out the evaluation of the business school. The evaluation team consists of evaluators and is headed by a chairperson. The institution shall purpose such set of the dates for the visit and the regular classes and all academic activity are on. The final decision made by the NBA will be communicated to the educational institution together with the comments which portray strengths, weakness and scope for the improvement. In the event that a business school is not accredited, reasons for the decision will be also be given. If accreditation is denied and if the educational institution wishes, it may appeal against the decision or to the appellate committee. The education institution shall bear the cost of the accreditation as per the fee prescribed by the NBA. Section 2, the accreditation process and the requisites. What are the accreditation processes there and what are the requisites are there? Introduction. The National Board of the Accreditation introduces a new accreditation framework for the accreditation of the business school imparting education in the management. The new framework has been developed incorporating the integrated input process output aspect of the business school and takes a holistic view of the business school. The board objective of the framework is to ensure a standard of the national and international level for the business school. Accreditation from the NBA provides an indication that the recognized school meet quality standard at the national level and also satisfied global standard. The manual on NBA accreditation explains the accreditation framework and provides information on the different criteria used for accreditation of the business school. A good understanding of the NBA accreditation framework is essential for effective self-assessment by the business school. It is desirable that the business school familiarize themselves with the accreditation criteria and procedure beforehand. This would be required for an effective participation in the accreditation process and making preparation in particular for the carrying out the self-assessment. The manual on NBA accreditation also includes section guide to self-assessment and guide to peer review, which are essential reading for a business school preparing for the NBA accreditation. Accreditation for the NBA provide business schools an opportunity for the assessment of their quality and guides them towards continuous improvement. This would help the business school to meet the quality standards nationally and move towards global standards. The main objective behind the NBA accreditation are to lead to the excellence in the management education, which helps them to meet the needs of the society, economy, and industry. To encourage institution for the capacity building. To lead to system process driven is the business school instead of the individual driven business school. To assist all stakeholders in identifying good business school. To be synchronous with the global standard. To be consistent with the international accreditation principle. NBA model. NBA model, the approach of the NBA accreditation toward measuring performance of the business school is holistic and looks at the business school program and activity as an integrated whole. In the following the input process output framework, the focus is on outcome-based perspective and criteria. This makes the business school responsive to its key stakeholder, mainly parents, students, industry, faculty, and society at large. The accreditation criteria based on the input process output framework is shown in the figure 1. The framework has separate areas for assessment or domains as shown in figure 1. The model is input process output based and all the domains are interrelated. The requisite area of the assessment are the number 1, organization mission, governance and collective leadership. Organization mission, collective leadership, strategy, quality assurance and the governance. organization mission, governance and leadership. Organization mission, leader and governance. This is the organization mission is shown here. Input process, enablers, student admission process, faculty recruitment, physical infrastructure, IT infrastructure, library, global input, quality assurance policy, finances, processing process, academic assessment process, placement process, research and development process, leadership and governance, MDP and consultancy process, faculty appraisal, department process, intellectual license process, staff appraisal, development of the production process, student overall development, feedback control, quality control system, outcome results, academic results, placement, value and ethics centric, entrepreneurship and the job creator, industry interaction, MDP, international global, research and innovation, stakeholder satisfaction, contribution to society. These are the NBA accreditation model. Institutions seeking accreditation are required to follow the above process for the successful accreditation. Input are enablers, are known are the input. What are the enablers are there? Student admission process, faculty recruitment, standard that relate to the learning goals, physical infrastructure, IT infrastructure, library, global input, quality assurance policy, and the finances. These are the enablers, input. Nine enablers are there, nine input are there. Nine enablers, nine inputs are there. Processing, processes, teaching, learning process, placement process, research and development process, leadership and government policies, MDP and the consultancy process, faculty appraisal, development and the promotion process, internationalization process, self-staff appraisal, development and the promotion process, student overall development, curriculum improvement process. These are the processing and the processes by which the institution can be improved. Outcome and the result. What are the outcomes are there? What are the results are there? What are the academic result is there? What is the placement is there? What is the value, ethics centric outcomes? Entrepreneurship and the job generation. How the entrepreneurship and the job creation is to be held? Industry interaction. How the industry interaction is there? MDP, Management Development Program, international global reach and the linkage. What is the global reach is there? What are the global linkages there? International linkages there? Research and innovation. What type of the research and innovation is done? Stakeholder satisfaction. Contribution to society. How the contribution to society are there? These are the outcome and results. So in part 4, we are discussing outcome and results. In part 3, we are discussing processes and the processing. Part 2, input and enablers. And part 1, organization mission, governance, and the collective leadership. To set up of the organization mission, to collective leadership, strategy, quality assurance, and the governance. Organization mission, governance, leadership, and the collective leadership. A brief description of the organization, outlining its background, purpose, and its present and future activities should be provided. The mission statement should describe the purpose of the organization and its objective and goals in this context. The details on the strategic intent and action should show a clear understanding of the environment and the markets in which the institution operates, including the assessment of its resources and constraints, the role and responsibility of the leadership in building vision and a strategy for the business school, and the process which establishes leadership should be spelled out. Governance issues which focus on the business school's activity along with its management aimed at integrating the organization and its activities should be laid down. Also, it is required that the process which makes this possible should be highlighted. Mission of the organization, a brief history and description of the business school, identity of the business school, relation with the parent institution, opinion for the senior management and the advisory board. Finance budgeting matters, statement of the income and expenditure, current and last 2 years. Program to be considered for the assessment, mission statement highlighting the purpose of the existence of the business school, its identity, its role in the society, its activity and the market, target population and the scope. This is the mission of the organization. Leadership, the vision of the leadership and the strategic direction it imparts to the business school, credibility and acumen of the leadership in building academic excellence in the business skill. Responsibility toward the ensuring quality, innovation and continuous improvement. Governance and accountability towards the institution. Governance and accountability towards an institution process which defines leadership in the business school. Emphasis will be laid of the collective leadership rather than of the individual leadership. Strategy, quality assurance and the government. Current position in the government environment of the business school operates in the program offered, employment market server, the output and the resource available. Competition, key stakeholder, funding agency, interface and the, of the business school with the job market, business schools, national, international market and competition, prevailing quality norms and the social environment. Vision for the future development. Future development vision must be there. Aspiration for the future. Progress towards meeting the vision. Related objective in the areas such as teaching and learning. Program development. Research. Pan-India framework, internationalization, corporate links, owning of a core value in the management profession, ethical and social responsible behavior, policy and process in the area of the quality assurance performance measurement, mechanism for the quality assurance policies for the periodic review, processes and indicator used to monitor overall performance, involvement of the key external and internal stakeholder in quality assurance process, periodic assessment, making the activity and process consistent with the mission. Governance system and practices following the principle of the effective and responsible governance. Principal stakeholder, internal and external, parents, student, alumni, company, academic expert, authority, government agency, and the more. Participative decision-making process. Principles and practices of the ethical and social responsible governance, competitiveness of resources in achieving the mission and the program objective. The input process are the enablers. What are the enablers of the systems are there? What are the input processes are there? Student admission process. This is the most important of the enablers of the input process. The standard and excellence of the program has its basis in the student intake. And therefore, one of the major concerns before the institute is its student intake and the intake process. The business school should focus on the selection process and the quality of the students enrolled. Clarity and adequacy of the selection criteria. Effectiveness of the selection process with respect to the intended target, target regions, and the profiles for intake in the various program. Current student population in terms of the origin, age, gender, education, and the work experience. Academic and professional qualification, other qualification, legal proficiency, rigorous, fair, and appropriate admission procedure based on a policy which is consistent with the mission and objective. Rigorous, fair, and appropriate admission procedure. This is important on a policy which is consistent with the mission and objective. Documented and published process which set admission criteria appropriate to the program that are offered and which are applied consistently to the all applicants. Regular evaluation, usage of indicator of ability and attitude. Requirement of submission of the official transcript of the credit earned from all institutions of the higher education previously attended. Clear guidelines whenever relevant of the conditional admission separately approved by the authority, including time limits and the requirement for moving to the final final admission. Norms for prior experience confirming with the program objective. Faculty recruitment. Faculty, this refer to the permanent core faculty and exclude member of the other institute employed on a part-time basis. These faculty members are the core group that builds up its unique expertise through the teaching, research, extension, and consultancy. Faculty resources and the faculty management would be in constant with the business school's stated mission and objective. Each business school should recruit faculty members to accomplish its mission with respect to the learning, practice, and scores. A variety of the faculty skills may be needed to meet the mission, and individual faculty members may be appointed to meet the specific aspects of the mission. The faculty size, qualification, and composition should be self-sufficient as program requirement. The workload should be reasonably balanced between the teaching, research, new program development, internal academic administrative responsibility, a full description of the current role core faculty as defined by the above of the following details. Number of the faculty members holding a doctoral degree. Number of the faculty members currently working towards a doctoral degree. The distribution of the faculty by the subject specialization. The age and gender distribution of the faculty. Justify the current size, composition, and qualification of the faculty. Profile of the faculty in terms of the expertise, academic qualification, lateral and longitudinal thinking, business experience, etc. Teaching faculty in terms of the numbers, qualification, and adequate coverage of the principal management disciplines. Interdisciplinary approach and the ability of the faculty to integrate a broad range of the subject. Main strength and weakness of the current faculty. Key areas of the shortfall in the faculty expertise and the action being taken to address this problem. How has the faculty evolved over the past 5 years? Faculty development activity that support maintenance of the academic professional qualification and should be sustained and sustained at the levels of the support, currency, and relevance for teaching and other missions related to professional responsibility. Student-faculty ratio, how has it evolved over the last 5 years? Future staffing plans, policy for recruitment, which meets the program objectives. Standards that relate to the learning goals. The business school should have a list of the learning goals for which it will be demonstrated facilitation of the learning. The list of the learning goals should be in consonance with the business school's mission. The learning goals should reflect the desired educational accomplishment of the degree diploma program. The learning goals must translate the more general statement of the mission into the educational accomplishment of the graduating students. Physical infrastructure. The business school should have the state-of-the-art infrastructure to support a learning environment for excellence. Physical facility in terms of the auditoriums, classrooms, breakout rooms, social space, etc. should be sufficient to support the specific pedagogical approach for each program. Summary of the premises, educational facility, auditoriums, classroom, breakout rooms, syndicate rooms, individual working station, social areas for the student, cafeteria, restaurant, common rooms, residential facility, functionality, and appearance and more. Details of the facility adequately equipped with the educational support material, computer access, projector, microphone system, etc. Details of the facility shared between the different programs. Shortfalls foreseen in physical resources in response to the institute's future strategy and steps taken to address this. Evaluation of the potential contribution of the faculty to the personal experience and development of the student. IT infrastructure. The business school should have state-of-the-art IT infrastructure to support a learning environment for excellence. Facilities available, hardware, software, internet, learning platform, open access computer, rooms, room, help services, etc. Adequacy of the computing facility provided with the adequate access outside normal working hours. Contribution of the computing facility and associated software to individual program objectives. Specific knowledge, skills, and quality developed through the use of the information technology and how these match program objective. Learning platforms available and how they are used by the faculty members in program delivery. Library and other learning resources are the key elements in achieving academic standard and excellence in terms of the teaching, research, and extension. The business school should have a proper library with excellent resources in the forms of the books, journal, other reading materials, linkages with the world of the work, audio or video, etc. The library should be continuously facilitate a learning environment on the campus. Library services provided on-site documentation center, library, database, research facility, etc. Adequacy of library and the research facility. Access to participant within and outside normal working hours. Special provision demanded by the international dimension of the institute's activity provided by the library and the research facility. Requirement for the future. Evaluation of the support provided to the individual by these facility. Procedure to obtain student feedback to develop facility for the benefit of the individual. Identifying the special relationship with the external library, including that of the parent institution, university, and the research institution. National and global input. National and global inputs are key to the success of the business schools program in today's national and global business environment. The program must develop a national and global perspective in the minds of the student, familiarizing them with the skills and the knowledge required for the business across different geographical regions. In order to achieve this, the institution should enrich this strategy and policy with the national and international perspective. These should also focus on building the collaboration with other national and international partner institutions in the area of the student exchange, faculty exchange, joint research, and national and international conferences and industry interface. The business schools should encourage students and faculty from the different regions and country to share and exchange view and experiences. And similarly, promote student and faculty to visit the institute and abroad. Evidence that the national and international dimension is reflected in institute's mission, governance, strategy, and the current operation. Details of the institute strategy and policy with regard to the global inputs. Process and resources available for putting national and global inputs in place. Designing program content from a national as well as the international perspective. Current level of the national and international orientation as reflected in the profile of the faculty and the student body. Institute's national and international activity, exchange, student abroad, faculty mobility, joint program, offshore operation, etc. Institute's network of national and international academic relations. Faculty, national and international experience of the faculty, visiting faculty. Student exchange program, opportunity to study abroad, mix of the national and international student. Key process used to manage the institute's national international policy and the relationship. Resources specifically allocated to the management of the institute national international activity. Adequacy of the institute international office. Procedure for establishing national international alliances and partnership and the criteria for the selection of the organization targeted for a special relationship. Institute's links to the national international corporate world. Relationship with the national international organization. History and competency of the partnering Indian foreign institution. Quality assurance policy. The business school should have a quality assurance policy in order to facilitate periodic verification of the quality of its activity and processes and similarity between the outcomes and the desired goals ingrained in its mission statement. The quality assurance process must include or ensure the following mechanism for the assessment of the consistency with the pursuit of the learning standard with due emphasis on the reflecting the finding of the latest research on the subject area. Mechanism for the achieving integration of the core areas and application of the cross-functional approaches to the organizational issue. National Board of Accreditation. Extent of the national and international dimension emphasized in courses. Process policy for evaluation of the learning outcome, assessment, placement, result. Alumni evaluation, student, peer, and alumni evaluation of the teaching and student achievement. Process for the linkage of the teaching performance, annual performance evaluation, institution's mission, institutional objective, and the program objective. Curriculum planning process for the orderly development of the curricula aimed at the realization of the institute's mission. Process for review and revision of the curricula. Process program for the assessment of the educational outcome in light of the stated program objective. Process for the review of the placement result in the light of the stated degree program objectives. Curriculum review process providing information from the stakeholder on alumni performance in the light of the stated objective as well as the relevant utilization of the in-house research. Demonstrate that student meet all the learning goals of the general management program. Define and demonstrate the achievement of the learning goals of the specialization offered in a program. Mechanism to ensure that the learning goals are accomplished, such as a sufficient time, provided content coverage, student effort, and student-faculty interaction. Evidence that the business school meets the learning goals for their respective programs. Finances. The business school should ensure sound and healthy finances for its immediate and long-term sustainable existence. In order to meet the requirement, it should ensure accountable and transparent practices, namely, current financial resources of the business school, income and expenditure account, funding sources, policy of the financial autonomy, development plans derived from mission, vision, statement, financial provision made for the such program, level of risk in the internal environmental market context, financial performance of the institute over the past 5 years, institute's internal financial control and the reporting system, determination of the extent of the devolution of the budgetary autonomy of the program directors, program heads, key performance indicator and monitoring mechanism and the policy, corporate governance issue and mechanism ensuring accountability to the stakeholders. Processes. What is the processes? Good processes for the business school. Academic assessment process. Process for designing programs in order to ensure that the design, content, delivery, and evaluation method of materials for the program are relevant, up to date, of the high quality. Issue of the interdisciplinary integration. Value, attitude, knowledge, skills, and behavior. Initiative to stay updated with the best practices, major trend, and significant innovation in the similar program in the country as well as around the world. Clearly stated objective and learning outcomes for the each program, conversion process of the program objective and intended learning outcome into the practical aspect of the program content. Means by which the transferable intellectual skills appropriate to the higher education are integrated in the curricula, such as analyzing, synthesizing, and critically assessing ability to think laterally and longitudinally, formulating and defending independent judgment, conceptualizing, communicating effectively in writing and orally, key managerial skills, teamwork, interpersonal skills, presentation skill, project management, and the leadership skill, etc., that the business school develop in its student and the method used to achieve them. Role of the practical work, internship, and projects in developing these skills. Opportunity to carry out practical project work, group work, and the practical experience. Training in research and the consultancy skills. Teaching method currently used in the program delivery, lectures, case study, business games, group work, project-based learning, tutorials, etc. Business school's initiative in promoting research and innovation in teaching methods and in the learning process. Extent of the integration of the information and communication technology into the program delivery system. Mechanism of maintaining quality control on ongoing basis. Criteria and process used to monitor that program quality relates to the program objective. Assessment system for the monitoring and graduating student work and progression through the program. Ensuring that the participant meet the agreed objective and learning outcomes for the individual awards. Assessment supporting the program design in terms of its learning objective and the general philosophy. Provision and policy for the assessment of the examination. Degree awarding mechanism and function handled by the institute, which upholds the integrity and validity of the process and prevents from the abuse by the individual. Steps taken to ensure objectivity in terms of the standard being applied. Evidence that the assessment regime is evaluated rigorously, particularly when new or the innovative approaches are being applied. Dealing with cases of the unethical practices such as cheating and the plagiarism. Demonstrating that the quality of the student's work is appropriate to the level of the program. Process for the evaluation of the program. Method means processes used to ensure that the program meet the needs. Process for the review and the revision of the programs. International content of the institute's program. Current arrangement with the other business institutes and the academic network for the joint delivery of the program. Building corporate perspective into the definition of the learning objective into the curriculum design. Formal process for involving corporate stakeholder in the program design and monitoring. Extent to which program integrate the main challenges in business society, such as the global responsibility, ethics, equality, and the sustainability. Evaluation process. Assessment of the evaluation process, whether external or internal, or a combination of both internal and external, moderation to the evaluation system and its method, whether external or the internal. Feedback process. Evaluation of the feedback from student, determination of its frequency, mode, which one time, formal, informal. Ascertaining whether the completion and analysis of the feedback is done and determining whether the appropriate action has followed. Revival of the inputs in the system of the feedback. Feedback from the employers. Placement process. Arrangement for the career development support on the campus for students and alumni. Interface between the business school and corporate world for the employment and the career support. corporate representation and support on campus, career days, forums and links to the international company. Different stakeholders involved in the evolution process, students, alumni and the company. Stakeholders' contribution towards improving the effectiveness of the selection, course monitoring and the career support. Budgetary provision for the purpose, for the process. Research and development process. The business school should demonstrate high level of quality in its teaching team, supported by the evidence from the management, research, scholarship, extension, and consultancy. Main types of the research and related activity carried out. Value added to the business school by all its activity that can be classed as research. Potential in the future and how this will contribute to the business school's mission and overall strategy. Process used to manage the business school's activity in this field. Faculty workload and the research. Normal expectation for the involvement of the faculty member in research and related activity. Reward and recognition for their contribution in this area. Policy to develop faculty potential in this area and how the results benefit individual program. Evidence of the joint research project within the country or abroad. Ability of the research endowment fund. Efforts made to seek sponsors research product and its rate of the success. Faculty contribution to the research article, teaching notes, industry notes, books, research monograph, case study, business schools research journal. Key area of the innovation in teaching learning methods, evolution method, developing new courses, new technology, new program. The business school's overall policy for the promotion innovation. The main evidence for the recognition of the business school at a national and international level as a center of the major research innovation. Leadership and the governance. Vision of the leadership and the strategic direction imparted by them to the institute and the encouragement of a process of the collective leadership at every relevant level. Extend to the vision reflects and national global aspiration. Principal stakeholder of the business school. Ensuring credibility and acumen of leadership in building academic excellence in the institute. To what extent the vision reflects national and global aspiration. Business school principal stakeholders. Involvement of the corporate leader in the governance of the institute. Contribution of the stakeholder on major issues such as the strategic planning, autonomy, and funding. School's organizational structure and decision-making process. Effectiveness in terms of the contributing to the overall mission. Operational autonomy within the business school. Key factors which underpin the business school's legitimacy. Process used to monitor overall performance. Description of the formal mechanism for the quality assurance. Ability of a full-time director and his tenure. Role of the director in the faculty recruitment and monitoring. Teaching competency of the director and the relevant feedback. MDP and the consultancy process. Portfolio of program and services offered in the area of the executive nutrition type of the program. Customized, residential, non-residential, online, distance learning, duration, short, long, modular, content, functional, general management, issue-based, skill workshop, action-oriented. Process for introduction of the new program and the range of the offering determined. School positional in the national and international market for the executive education. Composition of the business school customer base for the executive education, nature of the company market, size, level of the manager, senior executive, middle manager, specialist, technical, staff level, low-level manager, local, national, international. School's approach to customer relationship management and business school's marketing and the sales policy for its executive education activity. Extent of involvement of the faculty members in the promotion of the business school programs. Response time for the customized program. Pricing policy that is consistent with market positioning and the strategic intent. School's process for selecting and managing the participant in its program. Support process for participant before, during, after the training. Design process for open program and customized programs. Delivery methods used in the business school's executive education program. Approach to the management of the quality in its executive education activity and associated process for the monitoring, evaluation, and review of the program. School's policy on the consultancy assignment. Extent of the involvement of the faculty members in the consultancy assignment. Reward for the MDP, industry contribution, revenue generation, and the consultancy. Faculty appraisal, promotion, and the retention policy. Inclusion of the following is important for a comprehensive understanding of policy regarding the faculty appraisal and promotion in a business school. Full-time faculty members profile of the faculty in terms of the expertise, academic qualification, and the management experience. Faculty workload, adequate balance within the full-time faculty members. Workload between the direct teaching and the tutoring, program administration, innovation, course development, and the production of the teaching material. Research and publication, service to the profession and the wider community. Corporate involvement, member of the board, consulting, sponsored research, and the student projects. Faculty resource planning, consistent framework of policy regarding workload and the integration of the staff into the total teaching and the learning environment. Policy for the recruitment and integration on induction selection process. Policy for the exchange of the faculty with other institutions in the country, abroad, and the experience. Policy for the formal and periodic faculty performance evaluation. Process used for inducing, inducting staff, faculty development, evaluation of the contribution of the faculty development effort on the program, quality, and the general evaluation. Awareness towards the latest development in their field, awareness of the modern business practices. Specific programs identified to develop faculty for the future requirement of the institution and the community. Doctoral program. Budgetary allocation policy for this activity. Policy regarding faculty rewards, consulting, and the institution's experience. Faculty such as medical and housing supporting the faculty to attend international and national conferences and performance linked incentive to the faculty, etc. Planning process. Balance in activity in terms of the international dimension. Quality of the planning process. Evaluation of the relative effectiveness of the non-full-time faculty contribution and the business school's policy towards the part-time faculty. Measures taken by the business school for the retention of the faculty. Budgetary provision for the training of the faculty. National networking and the international process. National networking, international relation strategy, plans and policy, integration with the mission, governance and strategy of the business school. Key process used to manage the business school's national networking and international policy and relations. Adequacy of resources and staff for the international office. Processes and activity for proper positioning of the business school in the international market. Current level of the national networking. International as reflected in the A profile of the faculty and the student. Measured by the intercultural mix of the student and the international perspective in its program. National networking and international activity of the business school, student exchange, faculty mobility, joint program, offshore operation, etc. Scope, student exchange, faculty exchange, research collaboration, joint international conferences, and process for establishing international alliances and partnership, criteria for the selection of the organization targeted for the special relationship. Recruiting expert faculty, setting up campuses nationally and abroad. Nature and quality of the student exchange program, duration of the student exchange, term, credit transfer, etc. Faculty exchange and build. University rating, nature of the exchange, assessment of the work done during the exchange and visit. Staff appraisal, development and the promotion process. Policy for support services like finance and accounting, human resource management, building and grounds, documentation center, computation service, etc. Present status for the services listed above and determination of the sufficiency to provide adequate service to the business school activity. HR policy and related policy for all staff. Evaluation of effectiveness of the general support and administrative facility. Improvement in process for the quality enhancement. Student overall development. Processes create learning for students throughout their courses. Contribute to the individual personal development. The diagnosis and the correction of the learning needs and the career development. Identify the personal quality of the individual student which relate to the business school's mission and the potential contribution of the programs in the harnessing of these quality. Contribute to the soft skill, personality development, business language, and intercultural skills. Emphasize the role of the practical work and projects in developing these skills. Help integrating skills across the different subject area. Outcome. Results. Academic results. Trend of the last 3 years, details of the academic performance program wise, evaluation of the performance in the light of the program objective, contribution of the academic performance in achieving the overall larger objective of the business school. Placement, major trends found over the last 3 years, details of the student and placement type achieved, summary of information describing destination of the graduate, main destination, companies, organization, function, level of employment, salary levels, key employer, key trend, assessment of trend contributing to the achievement of its mission and the strategic objectives. Value and ethics, ethic-centric outcomes, evidence of the business ethics and corporate social responsibility integrated into the program design, outcomes and personal development of the students. Evidence of the clear code of the ethics for the management, faculty members, student and the support staff. Prominent display and implementation of the ethics code document, admission of the student, recruitment and promotion of the faculty member and staff, evaluation of the student and the faculty pedagogy and interaction with the industry. Evidence in terms of the value diversity among the employee. Sensitivity to the different culture. Providing equal employment opportunity. Ability to perform the job with regard to race, color, region, sex, disability, age, or the marital status. Evidence of working environment that is free of the intimidation or the harassment, especially sexual harassment. Entrepreneurship and the job creation. Evidence of the entrepreneurship skill built into the program design and the curriculum. Evidence of the entrepreneurship outcome, evidence of the means and policy which integrate entrepreneurship and skill building. Industry interaction, evidence that the corporate dimension is reflected in every aspect of the business school's mission, strategy planning, and the current operations. Summary of the following key areas: joint program, customized learning material, involvement of company in the curriculum design, case study work, project and internship, joint research program, company sponsorship, level of consultancy provided, corporate network, visiting faculty from the company, existence of the sponsored chairs, scope of the international company involvement. Management development program, MDP, key changes in the corporate involvement in the MDP of the business school that have occurred in the past 3 years. Major relationship developed with the corporate partner, extent of the partnership with the targeted company. Extent of the customer orientation. National, international, global reach and the linkage. Key changes in the national, regional, global operation of the business school that have occurred in the past 3 years. Future proposals that support the business school's strategy. Research and innovation, facility and expertise secured through the research work in the last 3 years. Outcomes, contribution to the mission and general teaching ability, main sources of the funding, research and carried out by the teams, existence of the self-standing research center, special facility and resources, staff expertise, general area of the expertise, details of the recent publication, research grant publication for the research and sponsorship. Key areas for the innovation for the business school, including development of the new courses, materials, teaching and delivery methods. Stakeholder satisfaction, alumni association and its activity are the last 3 years. Internal stakeholders feedback for the last 3 years. External stakeholders feedback comments including that of the patrons about the institutional activity for the last 3 years. Mechanism to strengthen public confidence in the business school system. Investment plan for the workforce in the coming years. Communication and interaction mechanism with significant stakeholders such as advisory body, consisting of the industry representative and the management experts. Mechanism and evidence to provide that the feedback has been followed by the appropriate action which has led to the significant improvement and the quality on that account. Contribution to the society, school's role within the wider community in which it operates, contribution to the management education profession, contribution to the business community in the form of the building small enterprises, dissemination of the knowledge. Contribution to the local, regional, national and global community. Future plan in the area of the next 5 year period. Contribution to the local issues of the governance, livelihood and the environment. Improvement in the second cycle of the accreditation. In the event of the institute seeking accreditation in the second or the higher cycle, the following have to be laid down. Changes that have occurred from the first to current accreditation. List of the practices which may be considered as the best practices of an institution of your kind and level. After an examination of the application and eligibility, the NBA may recommend mentoring or training program depending on the preparedness of the business school. Training program may be conducted by an organization accredited by the NBA. National Board of the Accreditation. Accreditation process steps, inquiry and the data sheet, application and data sheet for the accreditation. Eligibility, examination of application and eligibility. Mentor training program, NBA appoints mentor, suggests training program. Self-assessment, preparing the self-assessment report. Expert committee visit, visit to the expert committee to the applicant institution. Final accreditation, examination to the EC report, approved, conditional, rejected. Follow-up, submission of the annual report to the NBA. Re-accreditation, re-accredited after the 5 years. This is the NBA accreditation process steps, steps involved in the accreditation process. The following steps constitute the complete NBA accreditation process. Figure 2, application, inquiry, and the fact sheet. Preliminary interaction and the eligibility. Mentoring training program, self-assessment, expert committee visit, final accreditation report, follow-up, re-application for the accreditation. Application, inquiry, and the fact sheet after receiving approval from the competent agency, AICTA, in case of the technical institution, the business school is free to apply to NBA for the accreditation suitably. The business school will be required to send a formal letter of the application for the accreditation to the office of the NBA along with the fact sheet, providing basic information about the business school. The format of the fact sheet is available on the NBA website. This document helps to make a preliminary formal assessment of the business school and compare its status against the NBA criteria. Prior to applying, the business school must familiarize itself with the NBA criteria and the process. However, for any clarification and help required in completing the fact sheet, assistance may be requested from the board. Preliminary interaction and eligibility. The provision for the preliminary interaction tried to ensure that the business school and the management understand the NBA criteria and the procedure. This will be done by the NBA associate on site after the application and fact sheet have been received. The official shall also collect information about the institution on site and seek any clarification required on the information provided in the fact sheet. This visit would also provide an opportunity to interact with the selected key members of the institution and clarify doubts, if any. Eligibility criteria. The NBA committee should declare an institution eligible for the accreditation process provided the business school and its program are approved by the AICTA. However, this is not applicable for the university, their constituent institution, and the department. Mentoring training program. The business school may hire the services of the mentor on the panel of the NBA to provide assistance for the completing the self-assessment process. The guidelines for approaching the mentor, their work, role, duration, and fee, etc., may be obtained from the NBA. The business school may conduct training program for their staff and faculty members by the commissioning the services of the recommended nodal agency of the NBA. The guidelines for organizing training program may be obtained from the NBA. Self-assessment. Subsequent to the preliminary interaction and after receipt of the communication from the NBA, the business school will be required to carry out an extensive self-assessment exercise and to write a self-assessment report. This exercise can be completed with the help of the document guide to self-assessment. The duration set for this exercise is 3 to 6 months. The self-assessment report should be descriptive so as to allow an understanding of the business school's situation and to facilitate the work of the review team. The business school should avoid promoting itself in the report. Rather, it should be objective in its self-assessment against the criteria or standard of the NBA accreditation. The self-assessment report is provided to the NBA in the digital format. Expert committee visit. Once the self-assessment report has been submitted, a team of experts will visit the business school to review the understanding of the business school with regard to the accreditation standard and to draw up recommendations for the future progress. The peer review process is described in detail in the expert committee guide. The peer review is normally scheduled within the 2 months of the submission of the self-assessment report. The expert committee will be composed of the 3 members, 2 from the academic community and 1 corporate representative. The duration of the visit shall be of 3 years, during which the accreditation expert shall meet a wide variety of the people responsible for the different activity and interest of the business school. At the end of the peer review, the chairperson communicates its preliminary assessment to the business school orally and suggests direction for the future development. final accreditation report. The committees would submit the final accreditation report of the business school along with its recommendation for the future development and quality improvement to the NBA official. The expert committee in its report would recommend the suitable accreditation status for an appropriate period of the time as per the NBA policy from time to time. In addition, the expert committee shall also indicate area in which progress is necessary and suggest steps that need to be taken by the business school in the future. The business school may be awarded accreditation for a full 5-year term. A business school which has not been recommended for accreditation or accredited for a lesser period of time may reapply for the accreditation within a year's time. Follow-up. The business school should submit its annual report to the NBA. Reapplication for the accreditation. The business school which has not been awarded accreditation status is expected to follow the recommendation and direction of the expert committee within the stipulated time and reapply for the accreditation. Since the preparation for accreditation involves a significant amount of the time, the business school may do well to keep in mind to apply for the same much before the expiration of its current accreditation. Section 3 related with the self-assessment report. The purpose of the self-assessment. The purpose of the self-assessment. The broader objective of self-assessment is to provide the business school an opportunity for a comprehensive review of its status and bringing in better clarity of its day-to-day functioning. As a part of the NBA accreditation process, self-assessment provides a structure and a standard against which the business school can undergo self-evaluation. The self-assessment by the business school is one of the most critical and comprehensive inputs for the whole accreditation process. Broadly, self-assessment should focus on the following objectives. Clarity of mission and strategic objective. Clarity in understanding of the environment. A comprehensive strategic review identifies the key strengths and weaknesses. Evaluate the adequacy of resources, identify the key limitations, arrive at a clear understanding of the gap between what have been achieved and what its strategic objective are. Evaluation of the business school's effectiveness in the achieving its mission. Evaluation of the continuous improvement in the program and process quality. Identifying its current position against the accreditation criteria. Establishing the basis for the future action. Establishing quality improvement mechanism within the business school. Establishing greater understanding of the global and intercultural issues surrounding effective management practices. The assessment should be participative and involve as many people in the business school as possible, including the senior faculty and staff. It may be an ideal learning opportunity for the business school to provide a chance for everyone to gain an overview of its situation. It would present a historical perspective on how the business school has developed and how it sees its future. As this assessment provides a starting point for the peer review committee, the needs for the peer review committee should be considered carefully. The self-assessment report should provide important information, data, and documentation to facilitate the accreditation process and the present relevant facts. The self-assessment process. The following actions are recommended in designing and implementing the self-assessment process. The business school should appoint a project leader and an accreditation committee to manage the process and draft the report. At an early stage, the management team will need to provide a full explanation within the business school of the aim of the self-assessment exercise and of the standard against which the business school is measuring itself. The assessment process should involve all the key stakeholders who will need to understand the process if they are to contribute fully to the implementation of a plan for a rigorous self-assessment. Methodology. A detailed plan for conducting the self-assessment will need to be developed within no time of receiving communication in this regard. The business school will be required to develop a plan that meets its own specific needs. The self-assessment should be completed within the 3 months. In order to meet its objective, the business schools will need to establish a detailed project plan containing details of the main stages of the assessment. Methods to be employed, key issues to be addressed, responsibility and the participant, as well as time frames. Having decided the methodology for the self-assessment and the initial report of the format of the report, the business school will need to determine the information and documentation to be collected. It is useful to identify the key sources of information and allocate clearly the responsibility. The business school should seek to use as a wide variety of sources as possible to include internal and external report, e.g. assessment, accreditation, audit reports, program review, assessment result, exit surveys, special surveys, interview, and the focus groups. Self-assessment report. The following format is indicative of the self-assessment report. However, the business school shall finally decide its own format. The main report should be as a comprehensive as possible along with the supporting document. The parameters in the NBA accreditation framework document are formulated in the qualitative terms. However, the information provided by the business school should provide a scope to allow an assessment of the quantitative positioning of the business school in relation to the criterion. Business schools should pay particular attention to the indicator or evidence they use to position themselves in the relation to the different criteria. Activity summary should be placed at the beginning of the report, main body of the report. The report should be presented with cover information to include the following: name of the business school, name of the dean or director of the business school, name of the parent business school, if appropriate, contact detail, postal address, telephone, fax, email, date of submission of the self-assessment report, name of the individual to account for the question related to the self-assessment report, summary list of the all degree qualification and main programs offered by the business school, details of the internal review team and process used to produce the self-assessment report, a statement confirming to the accuracy of the report signed by the head of the business school, an updated version of the date sheet, annexed and supporting documents, authorship. The overall report should be a unified piece of the work. The detail must be entered under the supervision of the senior member of the business school. The report must be countersigned by the most senior representative of the parent body of the business school. Conclusion. The business school should present a conclusion which makes a case of the accreditation. Guide to preparation of the self-assessment report. The accreditation criteria are based on the input process output model as shown in the figure 2 of the section 2. The model indicates separate area of the assessment in drawing up the framework for the self-assessment and the structure of the report. It is important to emphasize that the business school should adjust the model to meet specific circumstances. The area of the assessment include the following: organization mission, governance and leadership. Organization mission, leadership, strategy, quality assurance and the governance. Organization mission: a brief description of the organization which familiarizes with its background, purpose and its present and future activities should be provided. The mission statement should describe the purpose of the organization and its objective and goals in the given context. The details of the strategic intent and action should show a clear understanding of the environment and the markets in which the institution operates, including an assessment of its resources and the constant role and responsibility of leadership in building vision and the strategy for the business school, and the process which establishes leadership should be spelled out. Governance issues which focus on the business school's activity along with its management aimed at integrating the organization and its activities should be laid down. Also, it is required that the processes which make it possible should be highlighted. Self-assessment should focus on the following aspects. The environment provides general information on the environment in which the business school operates. Detailed information to be provided in a separate document, program features. Student selection requirement, legal and regulatory framework, degree certification procedure, and the status of the degree. Historical construct, brief history of the business school since its inception, a summary detailing main events, creation of the program and teams, student members, teaching staff, support staff, facility and premises, budgetary details, etc. Description of the competitive environment and the constant, such as a key stakeholder, funding agency, and the computers, industry interface and the job market, prevailing quality norms and constant, if any, in freedom to innovate, access to the resources and support, access to the students. Vision and mission. Describe the business school's mission and explain how this relates to its identity. Describe how vision is converted into strategic and operational plan. Particular mention of how the coherence of the mission is maintained through all levels and activity. Demonstrate how the vision has been translated into the strategic objective as shown by the mix of the program, choice of the activity, establishment of the priority. Relationship between the business school's strategic objective and the ability of the resources. Key constant which limit the future performance. Describe the recent achievement in the pursuit of the strategic objectives. Leadership. Vision of the leadership and the strategic direction it imparts to the business school. Describe how credibility and acumen is built into the leadership, instrumental in building the academic excellence in the business school. Strategy, quality assurance, and the governance. Strategic positioning and the objective. Provide its current strategic plan and explain how this relates to the mission and strategic positioning of the business school. Describe the processes by which the strategic plan is developed, managed, and evaluated. Evidence that the industry orientation is reflected in its mission, strategic planning, and the current operation. Evidence that the regional or global dimension is reflected in mission, strategic planning, and the current operation. Governance. Describe the business school's principal stakeholder and assess their impact on their major issues such as strategic planning, autonomy, and funding. Provide a clear expression of the business school's legal status and affiliation, type of the organization, parent organization, legal status, and the bylaw. Relation to the national, regional, international education and accreditation boards, body, sources of the funding. Describe the business school's organizational structure, decision-making process, how effective is it in contributing to the overall mission? How is the operational autonomy ensured in the business school? Describe the process of for monitoring overall performance and the formal mechanism for the quality assurance. Input process enablers. Enablers are the student admission process, faculty recruitment, physical infrastructure, IT infrastructure, library, global input, quality assurance policy, and the finance. Describe student admission process. Describe the type of the student the business school is seeking to enroll. Use of the selection process, core support, and career planning to maximize the business school's contribution towards the individual development. Description and evolution of the performance in this area over the past 5 years and period, and the objective and plans for the next 5 year period. Relation of intake profile to the target profile in the business school's different programs. List the main action taken in the past and plan in the future to improve the mesh between the intake profile and career routes and the mission and the program objective. Description of the corporate involvement in the admission process and evaluate its contribution to the program success. Faculty and the faculty recruitment. Provide a basic description of the current faculty. Identify the key area of the expertise and the level of the qualification. Justify the current size, composition, and the qualification of the faculty against the business school's mission. Each strategic objective. Describe the business school's current deployment of the teaching resources, including both full-time and part-time faculty within its different program. Give appropriate ratio pertaining to the student member, full-time faculty, and the part-time faculty. Summarize the key changes in the faculty structure that have occurred in the last 5 years. identify the key areas of the shortfall in the faculty expertise and the action being taken to address this problem. Describe the staffing plan for the next 5 years with an explanation as how to these match the strategic plan. Physical infrastructure, evaluation of the adequacy of the physical resources and associated management system in meeting the business school's mission and program objective. Description and evaluation of the performance over the past 5 year period and the objective and plans for the next 5 year period. Summary of premises and evaluation of their overall adequacy to meet the demands of the business school's mission. IT infrastructure. Describe the IT facility available and evaluate their contribution towards the mission of the business school and individual program objective. Library. Describe the library and research facility available and evaluate their contribution toward the mission of the business school and the individual program objective. Identify any relationship with the library and the research school. National global input. Policy for national, regional, and global commitment, both for the students and faculty. Demonstrate that can educate students and participants in a regional and global environment. Concern for student exchange and general atmosphere for welcoming of students from other cultures. Pronounce policy for recruiting faculty from other states and the strategy deployed to involve academicians from other regions and noted business schools globally. Evidence that there are collaboration with the university and business school and abroad as well as visiting professors. Quality assurance policy. Procedure of the internal assessment done to ensure quality education and its continual improvement. Process ensuring that all activities support the overall goals and the outcomes of the business school. Finances. Summarize the financial performance of the business school over the past 5 years. Describe the process for the management of the financial resources within the business school. Evaluate the effectiveness of this process in meeting the demands of the business school mission and individual program objective. Processes, academic assessment process, placement process, research and development process, leadership and governance, MDP and consultancy process, faculty appraisal and development process, internalization process, staff appraisal process, student overall development process, teaching learning process, course preparation and progression. Provide a summary of the completion rates for each of the main program, trends and the action taken to respond to them. Process used in the course preparation and monitoring. Evaluate their success in maximizing student progress. Program quality. Evidence of the high standards in the quality of the program. Description and evaluation of the performance over the past 5 years period. Description of the objective and plans for the next 5 year period. Program design. Summary information on current position of the program. Link between the main types of the program offered by the business school and the overall mission. Process for managing the program design and how the business school ensures that programs meet the needs of the market and of the participant. Identify the key changes in the program design that have occurred in the last 5 years. Identification of the key constraint in the design of the current programs. Program content. Provide a summary of the key program objective, content and format, pedagogy adopted, core content, option offered. Evaluate the contribution of this program to the business school's mission and to the international management community. Program delivery. Describe the teaching methods currently used in the program delivery, lecture, case study, business games, group work, project-based learning, and tutorial. Policy and the pedagogical innovation and the use of the new technology in the educational process. Mechanism for maintaining quality control on ongoing basis. Explain how the criteria and process used to monitor program quality relate to the progress program objectives. Identify the main constant which limit the range or scope of the teaching methods and material employed in the business school programs. Student assessment. Process used to evaluate the assessment regimes used in the program. Innovation in the assessment of the students and explain how this meets the business school mission and the program objectives. Program evaluation. Process for the evaluation of the program meeting the needs of the market and of the participant and how it includes key stakeholders group in the process. Summarize the events, evidence for the satisfaction of the part of the key stakeholders groups regard to the program design. Relate this to the business school's mission, strategy plan, and the program objective. placement process. Describe the arrangement for the career development support on campus and for the alumni. Describe the interface process between the business school and corporate world for the employment and career support. Corporate apprenticeship and support for on campus, career days, forums, links to the international company. Research and development process. Describe the business school's overall research policy and the mechanism for determining research policy and the priority. Describe how research activities are integrated into the workload of the individual faculty members. Research as a requirement of the promotion and retention or not. Link between the faculty development budget and the research policy. Leadership and the governance. Summarize the process which defines leadership in the institute, keeping in mind the process of the collective leadership. Describe how leadership are responsible towards ensuring quality, innovation of the continuous improvement. Identify how governance and accountability are ensured towards the institution. MDP and the consultancy process. Description and evaluation of the performance in the MDP and consultancy area over the past 5 year period. Describe the key process used to manage the business school's relationship with the corporate world and list key relations with the corporate partner. Provide evidence that the corporate dimension of the MDP and consultancy is reflected in every aspect of its mission, strategy planning, and the current operation. Policy for the corporate relationship, joint research plan, company sponsors. Faculty appraisal and the development process. Faculty policy and the management. Process governing the operation of the faculty, policies and practices regarding recruitment, selection, induction, monitoring, and development of the faculty member, and whether these support the mission and strategy plan of the business school. Data and staff mobility, promotion, mobility, new staff, and on key areas of expertise brought in the last 5 years. Policy in establishing the balance between the teaching, research, consultancy, counseling, program development, and the management. Structure and process used to allocate responsibility and monitor performance across the organization and the performance. Faculty development and education. Describe current policy for the development of the faculty and explain how this supports the mission and strategic plan of the business school. Summarize the strategic plan for the development of the faculty and identify the key priority for the future and the budget involved. National networking and the international process. Assess the readiness of the business school graduate to manage in a national, regional, and the global dimension of the overall mission and program objective. This would include and the analysis of the relationship between the application, admission, and enrollment. Describe the key process used to manage the business school's international policy and the relationship. List key relationship with the national and international organizations. Policy for international cooperation, reflection in the mission. Existence of the international campus, details and policy on the exchange visit, joint program with the foreign business school, international program, curriculum content, contract, and the franchise arrangement with the foreign organizations, joint research program, sponsorship by the national institution, foreign organization, participation in the international network, business languages, skill development, development of the multicultural skills. Exchange programs or alumni participation in the international activity, alumni. Visiting faculty composition, exchange visit, existence of the intercultural teams, links to the national and international corporate work, involvement of the Indian and foreign company. Staff appraisal and development process. Organization of the support services, finance and accounting, human resource management, building and the grounds, documentation center, computation services. Description of the HR strategy and accompanying appraisal, development and promotion policy for all staff. Available of the sufficient administrative staff in the institute to provide adequate service to the participant and the customer. Provide details on the evaluation of the effectiveness of the general support and administration facility. Evaluation of the improvement in the quality of the support both achieved and proposed in the near future. Overall development of the institution. Student, role of the business school in developing the skills among the individuals that are appropriate and consistent with the business school's mission and individual program objectives. Description and evaluation of progress in this area over the past 5 year period and the objective and plans for the next 5 year period. Processes used to provide learning support for students throughout their course. contribution to individual personal development, diagnosis and correction of the learning needs and the career development, identification of the key personal skills which the business school aim to develop in individuals and how they relate to the business school mission and the potential contribution to the program towards the objective. Explain the role of any special technique and tools in diagnosing the personal quality of the individual student. Summary of the key practical skill which the business school develops in student and the methods used to achieve them. Discuss the role of the practical work and projects in developing and integrating skills across different subject area in contributing to the mission and individual program objectives. Outcome, results. What are the academic results? What are the placement? What are the value and ethnic center outcome? Entrepreneurship and the job creation, industry interaction, MDP and the consultancy, international and global, research and innovation, stakeholder satisfaction, contribution to the society. Academic result. Profile of the student's outcome. Identify the major trend shown over the last 5 years. Discuss how these trends have contributed to the achievement of its mission and strategic plan. Placement, summary information which describes the main destination of the graduates. Main destination, company, organization, function, level of employment, salary levels. Key employers, key trend, recent action taken. Employment trends and how they meet the stated program objective. Describe the main types of the student and corporate client saved by the business school. Identify the major trends shown over the last 5 years. Discuss how these trends have contributed to the achievement of its mission and its strategic plan. Value and ethics center outcomes. Describe means by which issues related to the business ethics and corporate social responsibility are integrated into the program design, outcome and personal development of the student. Prepare a list of the evidence to support the same. Entrepreneurship and the job creation. Describe means and policy which integrate entrepreneurship skill building into the program design and the curriculum. Describe initiative in details. Prepare a list of the evidence of the outcomes. Industry interaction. Describe the business school's relationship with the national and international corporate to evaluate its impact on the business school's mission, strategy plan, and the current operation. Description and evaluation of performance in this area over the past 5 year period. Describe the key process used to manage the business school's relationship with the corporate world and the least key relationship with the corporate partner. Summarize the evidence that the corporate dimension is reflected in every aspect of its mission, strategy planning, and the current operations. Provide details from the joint program, involvement of company in the curriculum design, case study work, projects and internship, existence of in-company programs, project and internship, involvement of company in career development support, alumni association, program support designed to equip individual for their chosen professional life, exchange and secondments to the staff, faculty composition, existence of the sponsor chairship, staff involvement with the company, visiting faculty from the company, provision of the specialist tuition by the company staff, company donations, scope of the international company involvement, international executive representative in the activity. Identify future proposals for the involvement of the corporate partner that will support the business school's mission. MDP, evaluate the key changes in the corporate involvement in the conducting of an in-house MDP and the consultancy. Identify future proposal for the involvement of the corporate partner that will support the business school's mission and the vision. National, international, global research and the linkage. Evaluate the key changes in the national, regional, global operation of the business school that have occurred in the past 5 years. Identify future proposals that will support the business school's mission and vision. Research and innovation. List the facility and expertise secured through the research work in the last 5 years. Identify the methods used to attract key staff to the business school in the last 5 years. Explain how these trends have contributed to the mission and general teaching ability. Summarize the research carried out over the past 5 years to include faculty expertise and the general area of the expertise, existence of the self-standing research center, main resources of the funding, special facility and the resources listed in the appendix detail of the recent publication, research grant application for the research and sponsorship. Summarize the key area for the innovation for the business school, including the development of the new courses, material and teaching and delivery methods. stakeholder satisfaction. Describe the business school's policy toward meeting expectation of the stakeholders, internal as well as external. Summarize the alumni activity in the last 5 year, involvement of the students and faculty in the decision making process, contribution to the society. The purpose of this section is to describe the business school's role within the wider community in which it operates. It should evaluate its contribution to the local, national, and regional and global community in the past 5 year period and describe plan in this area for the next 5 year period. Describe the role of the business school in the local, national, and international community. Describe how the business school manages external relations. Identify the staff and resources devoted to these activities. Describe key activity which lie outside of the normal teaching research over the last 5 years and proposal for the future. Explain how this contribute to the mission. Summarize the business school's overall contribution to the local national environment, its role in the developing the community or acting as a catalyst for the initiative. Contribution to the management, education profession. Contribution to the business community, the development of the small enterprises, role in providing the active forum for debate and the dissemination of the knowledge. Describe the business school's policy towards faculty development, involvement in the consulting activity in the service of the business community and as a tool for the faculty development. Describe the non-profit activity supported by the business school. Describe the role of the faculty in supporting extracurricular activity. Section 4 is the peer reviewer's guide. It is a peer reviewer's guide. The peer reviewer guide. The peer reviewer committee should consist of the 3 expert members from the field of the management education and 1 expert member from the corporate world. The committee will have as one of its members one who has had an earlier experience of the NBA accreditation process as a chairperson. The committee shall be guided by the objective of assessing the quality of the business school's management program and its activity against the NBA criteria. In its final report of the NBA board, the committee shall make a recommendation concerning the conduct accreditation. The committee may also suggest to the business school board directors, board directions for the future and the areas of the involvement. The committee is expected to go through the details of the self-assessment report submitted by the business school and verify the facts mentioned in the self-assessment report. The members will also be expected to sufficiently prepare themselves, follow up on discussion and the business school and maintain strict confidentiality. The concerned official at the NBA shall be in touch with the business school and arrange appropriate preparatory sessions, fix the timetable for the NBA assessment, and finally set the date of the expert committee visit, confirmation of the committee members' visit. Making the necessary arrangement for the travel accommodation with the business school will be coordinated by this office. The NBA project leader within the business school shall coordinate the self-assessment process and shall ensure timely submission of the report to the NBA. The project leader shall coordinate with the NBA official and make necessary arrangement for the expert committee visit. The business school shall conduct all necessary logistic arrangement for the director's visit, including local travel and accommodation. The chairperson of the committee shall review the self-assessment report and collect the views of the other committee members. As and when required, the chairperson may take a request for the further information advanced through the NBA. During the review process, the chairperson shall ensure adequate preparation for meeting and delegate leader responsibility to the individual. The chairperson shall ensure completion of the assessment document before the end of the visit and should hold a meeting of the committee members for deciding on its conclusion and the recommendation. The business school shall be briefly broadly about the committee's opinion. Subsequently, the chairperson shall ensure the submission of the report to the NBA. The individual committee member are expected to prepare themselves adequately about the objective of the assessment and the criteria used to make a balanced decision and support the work of the team of the chair. List of the document to be made available to the committee members before the visit. Name and address of the member of the review team. NBA accreditation standards. Guide to the self-assessment. NBA expert committee guide. Business school profile sheet. Criteria selection checklist. Self-assessment report of the business school under review. Fact sheet. The work of the expert committee normally should start with a brief meeting so as to reach an agreement on the working methods and the allocation of the responsibility within the expert committee. Then the meeting can be organized once all the members have assembled in a hotel a day in advance. A review of the self-assessment report and identification of the key issue should be done, and finalization of the schedule and preparation of the review meeting with the business school should be completed. Documents and evidence for the following shall be made available to the expert committee on the day of the visit: library books, database usage statistics, brochure and magazines of the business school, performance feedback form from employer for 3 years, logbooks of using different resources such as sport facility, computer, etc., feedback forms from the student for the last 3 years. A tentative schedule is indicative below, which can be used as a guiding reference. However, the committee shall have the authority to finally draw up the plan assessing the requirement on site. Meeting with the top executive, 1 hour and 30 minutes. Governance representative of the business school governing body, 1 hour. Program direction, program directors of the different program and consultation, 1 hour and 30 minutes each. Faculty management, dean of the faculty, for those responsible for the faculty management, 1 hour. Research, 1 hour. Subject specialist, 2 or 3 subject area heads, 1 hour. Faculty, a random group of the faculty member, this should be different from the senior staff already made, 1 hour. Expert committee can be broken up into subcommittee and should meet 2 groups of the 5 to 6 faculty member. Support services, representative of the student services, admission, international office, placement and career scheduled separately, 45 minutes. Student from the different program seen separately, 45 minutes each group. Students should be met after the program direction. The expert committee can be broken up in the 2 subcommittee. Corporate connection, representative of the key corporate customers, advisory board, 45 minutes. Alumni, 30 minutes. 10% names to be given by the alumni session who will be available to meet. This should be provided in advance to the expert committee, out of the which the committee will decide to meet a few. Resourcing, the meeting will focus on the physical and financial resources available to the business school in view of its development plan. It will also be an occasion to examine the financial management system that provide information for the business school program directors. 1 hour. Class visits, 30 minutes each. Conversation with the head of the finance. Final debriefing, 45 minutes. Part of the program, maximum 45 minutes should be set aside the look at the facility, lecture hall, working group rooms, library, etc. For this, the team can split if necessary. An open slot should be organized to allow individual staff and student to talk to the members of the panel. The key issue that the preview reviewer should focus on when preparing for interview is to identify the additional information required to arrive at a final assessment predetermined by this identified shortfall. Students are a very rich source of the information, but their comments need to be verified against the information given by the faculty members. Interview with the students should aim at gaining important insight regarding workload, professionalism of staff, coherency of the program, clarity of aims and objective, organization of the curricula and the facility. The interviews with the students should be held in the absence of the faculty member so that they can speak freely. Each group should normally be made up of the 6 to 10 students, all from the same program. The group should be representative of the whole student population within a particular program, and the business school is best advised to ask a student organization to nominate the student. If this is not appropriate, steps should be taken to invite a student at random. Students from the widely different programs should not be mixed. Interview with the faculty staff are conducted to discuss the issue around research, the design and delivery of the program, and the overall management of the faculty. Confirmation of the issue raised by the student can also occur. As with the student, the base size of the group is probably a reasonable sample of the about of the 6. Concluding meeting. In our concluding meeting, the committee should brief the senior management about their board opinion of the assessment, which may include the strength of the business school in certain area of the session, area of the improvement. Award of the accreditation. scrutiny and acceptance of the application for the accreditation, for applying for the accreditation by fulfilling the online form and submitting the SAR. All business schools that apply for the accreditation will not be entitled for the undergoing the accreditation process by the default. Only those applications that meet the desired criteria will be accepted by the NBA for the undergoing the accreditation process. Policy guideline. Maximum marks allocated in the accreditation are the 1200 marks. It is important that the assessment happen in a transparent manner and an institution can ask for the review as well as go for the appeal. Proviso is made to appeal. Based on the assessment, the program of the business school will be accredited as follow. Full accreditation, provisional accreditation for the 2 year, no accreditation awarded. Full accreditation, the business school demonstrate outstanding quality well above the level required to satisfy the NBA standard in this area, and it is considered as a model of excellence. Full accreditation may be awarded to such business school for the 5 years. The necessary condition for the award of the accredited status for the 5 years is the securing 900 marks or the above marks, minimum 60% marks in each part of the assessment, governance, input, process, and outcome. Provisional accreditation. The business school satisfies partial criteria for the NBA student standard in this area. As defined in the criteria framework, such business school may be awarded partial accreditation for the 1 year only. This may be rewarded after paying the requisite fee for the another 1 year. The necessary condition for the award of the provisionally accredited status for the 2 years, securing between the 720 to 899 marks and the minimum 45 marks in each part of the assessment, governance, input, process, and outcome. No accreditation awarded. The business school is considered to be below the threshold of the NBA standard in this area. The institution secured 719 marks or below does not satisfy the necessary condition required for the accredited or provisionally accredited status. Re-accreditation of the provisionally accredited institution. Business schools which are the provisionally accredited can apply for the re-accreditation after the completion of the 2 years. If the provisionally accredited status is awarded successfully for the 2 times, the business school will have to wait for the 2 more years after the expiry of the period of the second time awarded provisionally accredited status. After the cooling period is over, the business school may apply for the re-accreditation again. Appealing committee. Appellate committee. A business school may approach the appellate committee on being not accredited for the undergoing the process of the accreditation, on being given not accredited or provisionally accredited status. Guidelines for the evaluation. The checklist is to be read in conjunction with the reference to all items and norms of the evaluation. The score for the non-conformance on any dimension in all cases will be 0. With credible evidence in each case, low, medium, high, and the numerical evaluation will be in the interval of the next to higher bound of the preceding level and the higher bound of the current level. Institution of evaluation for section 1.6. If the criteria is not met, 0 marks can be given in the case of the non-performance. As per the checklist, if the criteria fulfilled for the case is low, then evaluation can be between 1 to 5 marks depending on the fulfillment of the criteria. Similarly, for the medium case, between the 6 to 9 marks, and for the high case, between the 9 to 10 marks and can be given. Fractional marking should be avoided. Summary of the peer review record. The stages involved in the peer review process are the as follow. Individual assessment and completion of the document using the criteria satisfaction checklist and business school profile sheet. Consideration of the finding in the final committee briefing meeting. Consideration of the criteria satisfaction checklist. Agreement on the business school profile scoring. Agreement on the expert committee final decision on the accreditation. Preparation for the debriefing of the business school oral report, the concluding meeting and the debriefing of the business school, preparation of the NBA report. Few important points for the expert committee visit. On completion of the self-assessment report, the business school should ask the NBA office to schedule the expert committee visit. The date of the team visit shall be mutually decided between the business school and the NBA office, keeping in mind the ability of the potential members of the team. The business school shall send the NBA office a proposal 1 month in advance, detailing the schedule of the visit prepared in accordance with the guidelines provided in the expert committee guide. This schedule will be reviewed by the NBO office and changes to it may be proposed. When the schedule is considered satisfactory, it will be sent to the chairperson of the team for the comments or the approval. The team that carries out the on-site visit is composed of the three members, two from the academic community and one corporate representative. One of the members of the team will be appointed as the chairperson by the NBA office. The visit should be normally start with a private meeting of the members of the team in order to streamline the review meeting and determine the issue on which the emphasis should be placed. The peer reviewers are already provided with the self-assessment report of the business school, its fact sheet and the report of the preliminary visit. At the end of the team's visit, the team shall present to the top management of the business school the team's preliminary conclusion and recommendation for the quality improvement during an overall feedback session. That the team then submits its report setting out the team's assessment of the institution against the NBA quality criteria and providing recommendation for the future development of the institution. The report, after receiving a consensus approval by the all members of the team, is then sent by the office of the NBA for the approval of the final recommendation and communicating the award rejection of the accreditation. Timing and the deadlines. This is a certain deadline or period limit to be met in the NBA process. These are the following. The date of the team visit should be determined at least 1 month in advance. The eligibility briefing session for the business school should take place no later than 1 month after the receipt of the fact sheet by the NBA office. The self-assessment report should be submitted to the NBA office 6 weeks before the close of the on-site visit to allow time for the team members to read the report and prepare the schedule for the expert committee visit. Fee schedule. Fee schedule for the initial accreditation is normally given in the NBA website. Mentors guided development training program. Registration fee is 20,000 to be paid once when applying for the guided development. Advisory fee is 15,000 per day. Fee for the training program may be decided on the basis of duration of the program. The NBA expert committee report. Once the evaluation of the business has been completed, the expert committee should reach a final decision so as to whether the business school meets the standard for the NBA accreditation. If the business school is found not to have made the standard, then the shortcomings have to be fully defined. Also, the committee must suggest action necessary to meet the shortfall. The recommendation must be clearly sustained with reference to the observation made in the criteria satisfaction checklist and assessment set out in the consolidated business school evaluation sheet. The final report to be submitted to the NBA is an extremely important document, both for the accreditation awarding body, but also the business school. Great care is recommended in writing this report, and the following schedule should be followed. The chair should collate and consolidate comments from that team using the written summary in the criteria checklist and minutes of the oral presentation. The chair should then write up a draft of the report and circulate it to the team for the comment. Following the receipt of the comments from the team members, a final editing of the draft is to be completed. And the final report is written by the chairperson and submitted to the NBA. Recommended format. Recommendation for the NBA. Recommendation, non-binding. Presentation, title page, presentation of the business school, 1-2 page. Basic concept, description of the business school, main program, etc. Paragraph on the self-assessment report, coverage of the NBA criteria framework, adequacy of the information provided, quality of the self-analysis, timely submission. Description of the assessment visit. Summary of the event, schedule for the visit, items not included in the original schedule, problems relating to the organization of the visit, cooperation from the business school, access to information, exceptional items. Main body of the report, general assessment of the business school, 1-2 page, detailed analysis of the following the NBA accreditation guide, 6-8 pages. Section 5. Benefits of the accreditation. What are the benefits of the accreditation are detailed here. Benefits of the accreditation. The benefits of the NBA accreditation stems from the four main and often interrelated area. research funding and additional seat for the capacity expansion of the business school. Assessment of the quality of the business school based on the several criteria with reference to a more or less expertise standard. Brand recognition and appreciation derived from being granted a merit or distinctive accreditation level. Advice and action contributing to the actual improvement of the business school. Research funding and benefits of the additional seats. The main role of the National Board of Accreditation is to guarantee to the general public that business schools follow quality standards required to operate as a business school. The NBA accredited business school may be eligible for the AICTE research funding, and it allows them to expand their student intake capacity. Quality assessment of the business school based on the NBA criteria and the standard. Accreditation is market driven and has an international focus. It assesses the characteristics of the business school and its program against a set of the criteria established by the National Board of Accreditation. The senior academics and the corporate representative who sit on the board constantly monitor the accreditation criteria. Through accreditation, business school provide stakeholder with the assurance that they guide educational delivery with the help of the carefully constructed mission. Select and support students to produce outstanding graduates. Deliver degree programs with the qualified faculty. Structure learning through the relevant curricula. Contribute to the knowledge through the research and scholarship. Ensure the quality of the professional managers. An accreditation process is established to secure these objectives. Brand recognition and appreciation. In addition to the benefits provided to the business school by the professional assessment through a meaningful quality framework against challenging standards, the NBA provides a seal or label that differentiates the accredited business school from its peer at the national level. This differentiation, if adequate, drives the business school to a more widespread recognition and to greater appreciation of its brand name. The degree of the awareness among the business school students as they progress through their program about the merits of their one business school enjoying the NBA accreditation is slowly increasing due to the business school's one publicity. Benefits to the business schools. The key objective of the NBA is to contribute to the major significant improvement of the business school involved in the accreditation process. Significant improvement means the improvement of the substance or essence of the business school. Participation in the NBA accreditation process affirms the business school's responsibility for the quality of the education offered and demonstrates its commitment to the continuous improvement. The NBA accredits quality improvement for the individual business school. It is often seen as an instrument of the business school's strategic development and effective way to influence the business school's management team to establish a clear agenda for the change in an improvement. The business school entering the NBA process recognize that there are a lot of details about their performance, both good and bad, and that are brought to their notice for the first time while preparing their self-assessment report. Of as good academics, we subject our own business school to criticism. By undergoing self-evaluation, a business school assesses planning and goal-setting process and measures accomplishment against an objective. However, it is often done informally and on the basis of incomplete and involuntary biased information. The self-assessment phase allows a business school to go through this process in an orderly and coherent manner that facilitates direction, detection of the actual problem, and facilitates the business school to develop its own solution for them. The peer review committee visit by the two experienced academicians and one member of the corporate world provides a new occasion for the substantial improvement. First, it creates a sense in the business school that quality assurance is a real concern which must be shared by all. Second, by means of the question and the session, those interviewed get insight on ways to improve the area they are responsible for. Finally, through an oral debriefing plus a written report, the expert committee provides a thorough assessment of the quality of the business school as well as required for the suggested action or the improvement. The expert committee also provides advice and counsel, thus offers new perspective on the business school's operation. Benefits to the student. The business school program has an appropriate mission achieved through the relevant curricula, qualified faculty, and effective policy and practices. Through accreditation, the degree program offered completes a rigorous self-evaluation and the peer review. The degree program offered satisfied criteria established and accepted by the management education and community which the NBA represents. Student and studying in B school accredited by the NBA can be assured that they will receive a balance between the high academic quality and the professional relevance that niche to the of the corporate world are integrated into the program activity and the processes. Benefit to the employers. Accreditation ensures prospective employer that students come from a management program where the content and quality has an evaluated, satisfied, established standard. The employer can be confident that the management program includes an understanding of today's complex business environment and the program offered is current, reflecting changes in the knowledge and practices generally accepted in the management education community. Benefits to the public. Accredited status represent a commitment of the program and the business school to qualify and continuous improvement. The business school program has a clearly defined mission and educationally appropriate objective. The business school program has voluntarily undertaken a self-evaluation and the peer review. Catalyst for the international accreditation. The result of the accreditation from the NBA, the business school system and the procedure are aligned with their mission and vision. All essential prerequisites for the international accreditation are included in the NBA. Therefore, the NBA acts as a catalyst for the business school applying for the international accreditation. Section 6, Annexures. Annexure 1, Program Summary, Format for the Self-Assessment Report, Name of the College Institution, Name of the Contact Person for the NBA, Designation, Telephone Number, Mobile Number, Email ID. History of the college institution, including the date of introduction, number of seats in the various program of study along the NBA accreditation, if any, in tabular form. History of the B school, attach additional seats if space not sufficient. Program of the study description for each program. PG in management started with seats intake. Intake increased to in accredited by the NBA CTA in 4 years. List the names of the program, we share human resources and for the facility. Total number of the intake capacity, boys and girls. Total number of the admitted student, boys and girls. Total number of the foreign student, boys and girls. Total number of the employee, male and female. Minimum and maximum number of the faculty and staff on the roll during the current and previous year. Academic year, 1st July to the 30th June of the program. Teaching faculty in the marketing, required existing. Marketing, finance, general, HR, operation, system, non-teaching staff, government, central, state, or private NGO. Summary of the budget for the current financial year and the actual expenditure incurred in the current financial year minus one, current financial year minus two. Exclusively for the program, office expenses, budget in the current financial year. Library, books, periodicals, journals, purchase, upgradation of the software, online databases, etc. Computer laboratory, internet laboratory, purchase of the hardware for upgradation of the computer. Legal software purchase for the upgradation. Placement activity, seminar, workshop, conferences, cultural facility, debates, etc. Miscellaneous expenses for the academic activity. Institutional summary. Name of the college, institution and address. Name of the contact person for the NBA. Designation, telephone number, mobile number, email ID. History of the college, institution, including dates of introduction, number of seats in the various program study along the NBA accreditation in tabular form. History of the B school, college institution. College institution start date the following program with the intake capacity year. NBA CTA accreditation visit and accreditation granted if accredited by the NBA CTA 4 years. Addition of the new program, increase intake capacity of the existing program or accreditation status. Ownership status. Government, central, state, trust, society, government, NGO, private, others specified. Financial status, government in aid, not for profit, private, self-financing, others specified. External sources fund. Name of the external sources. Internally acquired funds. Name of the external sources, student fee. Scholarship or any financial assistance provided to the student, yes or no. If provided, basis of the scholarship, assistant, merit and fee, economically backward class, other. number of students amount in CFY, number of students amount in CFY minus 1, number of students amount in CFY minus 2, basic examination for admission to the management education, all India entrance, state level entrance, other specified. Total number of the intake capacity, boys and girl. Total number of the admitted student, boys and girl. Total number of the foreign student, boys and girl. Total number of employees, male and female. Minimum and maximum number of the faculty and staff on roll, the business school, faculty during the CYBA and the previous current year, academic year. Teaching faculty in the marketing, finance, general, HR, operation, system, non-teaching staff, government, central, state, private, NGO. Budget allocation and its utilization. Summary of the budget for the current financial year and the actual expenditure incurred in the current financial year minus one. Acquisition of the land and new building and infrastructure buildup. Office expenses, teaching salary and non-teaching staff salary. Library, books, periodical, journals, purchase, upgradation of the software. Computer laboratory, internet laboratory. Purchase of hardware for the upgradation of the computer. Legal software, purchase of the upgradation. Placement activity, seminar, workshop, conferences, cultural festival, debates, etc. Miscellaneous expenses of the academic activity. Business school evaluation sheet, annexure 3, name of the business school, date of the evaluation of the expert committee, organization, mission, governance and leader, 120 marks, allotted point, remarks, hearing. Input enabler, 360 points. Student, 35 marks. Faculty, 50 marks. Physical infrastructure, 40 marks. IT infrastructure, 50 marks. Library, 50 marks. Global input, 35 marks. Quality assurance policy, 40 marks. Finance, 55 marks. Processes, 360 points. Academic assessment process, 100 marks. Placement process, 40 marks. Research and development process, 45 marks. Leadership and governance, 20 marks. MDP and consultancy process, industry extraction, 75 marks. Faculty appraisal and promotion policy, 40 marks. Internationalization process, 20 marks. Self-appraisal development and promotion process, 20 marks. Outcome result, 360 points. Academic result, 55 marks. Placement, 60 marks. Value and ethic centric outcome, 25 marks. Entrepreneurship and job creation, 10 marks. Industry interaction, 55 marks. MDP, 36 marks. International Global, 24 marks. Research and innovation, 30 marks. Stakeholder satisfaction, 40 marks. Contribution to the society, 25 marks. Total, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1200 marks. Organization, mission, governance and leadership, 120 marks. Clarity of the mission, maximum marks 6. Allotted. If you take effectiveness of the B school governing body, 20 role and scope, 6 marks allotted. Clarity of the strategic objective, 6 marks allotted. Periodic assessment for making of the activity and process consistent with the mission, 7 marks allotted. Alignment between the B school's culture and operational values, 6 marks allotted. Match between the strategic objective and resources constant, 7 marks allotted. Effectiveness of the external and internal decision making structure and coherence of the external and the internal decision making structure, 6 marks allotted. In the B school strategic position revised every 3 years, 6 marks. What is the allotted mark? Outline the process of the innovation and continuous improvement, 10 marks allotted marks. Outline strategy to meet excellency. Corporate involvement in the B school functioning, 8 marks allotted marks. Are the main function characteristics reflected in the mission vision B school, 6 marks allotted marks. Robustics of the formal mechanism for the internal quality assurance, robustics of the process and indicators used to monitor overall performance, 7 marks allotted marks. Collective leadership and its vision for the B school and its excellence, 7 marks allotted marks. Accountability for the decision making to the institution process, 10 marks allotted marks. Wage adopted by the B school to continuously won the stated core values, 10 marks allotted marks. Competitive to resources in the achieving the mission and program objective, 6 marks allotted marks. Input enabler, 36 points. Students, transparency in the selection process of the student, 8 marks allotted marks. match the number of between the intake capacity and the number of student admitted 6 marks, quality of student enrolled 6 marks, the consistency between the application and practice of the admission process outlined in the announcement and actual admission activity 5 marks, the nature and approval of the requirement for determining the guidelines for the admission and identification of the competent authority 5 marks, correlation between the quality of admission and the final results 5 marks, total points 35 marks, faculty sub criteria conformity or conformity of the total number of W faculty to the benchmark as per the norms of the ACTA 6 mark allotted marks, faculty student ratio as per the norms of the ACTA 6 mark allotted marks, or outline ratio between the full time faculty and the part time faculty 6 marks allotted marks, faculty qualification as per ACTA norms 6 marks allotted marks, average period of the faculty retention 6 marks allotted marks, outline the recruitment promotion and policy of the faculty 4 marks, outline the nature and extent of the faculty to the world of the work 4 marks allotted marks, outline the policy and faculty development with the specific instances of its observation 4 marks allotted marks, policy of the B school for the use of the outside expert for the curricular activity 4 marks, evidence of the research and aptitude of the faculty 4 marks, total points 50 marks, physical infrastructure, nature of the geographical access maximum marks 6 allotted marks, infrastructure for support of the quality education in terms of the learning and environment, space facility in terms of the auditorium, seminar rooms, conference rooms, classroom, cafeteria, open space, recreation faculty, syndicate rooms 6 marks, the extent to which the teaching rooms are equipped with their learning aids 6 marks, the nature and extent of the common academy facility with the non-management program 5 marks, landscaping and aesthetics of the campus 6 marks, adequacy of the hostel facility to meet the daily requirement of the student life 5 marks, total points 40 marks, infrastructure sub criteria, the extent of the technical competence of the supporting staff in ICT 5 marks allotted marks, elaborate with illustration the nature and extent of the use of the instructional kits 5 marks allotted marks, elaborate on the state of the art of the hardware and software in the computer laboratory 7 marks allotted marks, the extent of the access and usage of the internet learning platform computers, the extent of the electronic inline systems access in the residential and recreation part of the campus, the extent of the access and usage of the video conferencing and management related software, ability and maintenance of the learning platforms and the extent of their use by the faculty 12 marks, total point 50 marks, library books 6 marks allotted marks, journal e-journal national international 2+2+2 6 marks, ability of the online databases 6 marks, ability of the management films and other storage material and the extent of their usage 5 marks, range of the library management software Slim One, Libsys, Libsuite, Soil, etc. 8 marks, nature of the support services for the fieldwork 6 marks, working hours for the library and the reading room 6 marks, channels of the users of the feedback and extent of its utilization 6 marks, extent of the internal library network 6 marks, global input, policy of the B school for national and international collaboration 8 allotted marks, quality of the B school's national and international academic patterns 5 marks allotted marks, appropriation for the main national and international strategic alliances 5 marks, the nature and nature of the national and international exchange program 6 marks, quality of the B school national and international corporate partners 5 marks, research collaboration with the other institution 6 marks, total point 35 marks, quality assurance policy, record of the maintenance of the implementation of the B school's assurance policy 8 marks allotted marks, nature of the internal assessment process to ensure quality management education 8 marks allotted marks, finance sub criteria, ability of the sound and healthy finances for the long term sustainability existence of the B school 8 marks allotted marks, the extent of the financial subsistency of the B school 8 marks allotted marks, financial performance of the B school in the preceding 3 years 7 marks, nature of the B school's internal finance control and reporting system 8 marks, nature and scope of the performance indicator monitoring system of the staff and faculty activity 8 marks, scope and range of the funding sources 8 marks, wage of ensuring accountability 8 marks, allotted marks, total points 55 marks, processes 360 points, academic assessment process, the nature and coherence in the B school portfolio programs, 4 marks, allotted marks, policy and provision of the student's evolution process, effectiveness of the program designed to ensure that the content delivery methods and material are relevant, up to date and high quality, 9 marks, program and practices used for the development of the manager's skill in terms of the practical work, summer placement, project work, group work, training in research and consultancy, etc., 8 marks, process of review and revision of the program with reference to the business industry need, 8 marks, the nature of involvement of the corporate stakeholder in the program design and delivery, 4 marks, the extent to which the emphasis of the learning methods is ongoing, giving the student an ability to renew his her learning, 8 marks, quality of the course materials distributed, if any, 4 marks, the regularity of the program monitoring and review process, evaluation by student, faculty and student committee, 4 marks, quality of the program administration, 8 marks, compatibility with Indian and global business partners, 7 marks, the extent to which the students are encouraged to develop a personal development agenda, 7 marks, the extent to which the B schools program instill professional ethics, 4 marks, the extent to which the B schools program instill societal concern, 4 marks, the extent to which there is an opportunity for the practical work, project work based, 3 marks, the extent of the opportunity available to the develop communication skill, 8 marks, the extent to the opportunity available to the develop cross cultural skills, 6 marks, total points 100 marks, placement process, quality of the student place, extent and attractiveness of the job offers, 6 marks, nature of the relationship of the placement to the core curricular activity of the B school, inspiring that the core activity did not shatter on account of the placement work, 12 marks, the nature of the student counseling services, 6 marks, nature of the corporate involvement in the recruitment and the placement process, 6 marks, nature and of encouragement and provided of the core curricular activity, 5 marks, the extent of the support of provided of the student industry interaction, 5 marks, total points 40 marks, research and development process, extent of the operational support provided for the research and development activity, 7 marks, the extent to which the research is used to curricular development and updating institutional tools, 7 marks, nature and quality of the institutional research output, 11 marks, the utilization of the institutional research by the corporate world of work, 11 marks, support provided for the faculty development linkage with the outside world, 9 marks, total points 45 marks, leadership and the governance, the extent to which the board of the governance is an actual player in the decision making process of the B school, 8 marks, percentage of the board members with actual background of the research and development, 6 marks, the role of the board in the B school corporate movement and HR decision, 6 marks, total point 20 marks, subcriteria, quality of the MDP program delivered, 12 marks, number of corporate organization which come back repeat in utilization for the B school extension facility, 12 marks, nature of the company or organization, sector size which utilize institution facility, 4 marks, the nature of the breakup of the people who utilize MDP in the preceding 3 years, 9 marks, the process used to measure the impact of the learning input on individuals and organization, 9 marks, extent of the faculty involvement in the executive education, 6 marks, the nature of the overall customer orientation of the B school, 7 marks, describe the nature of the links to the corporate world and their level of the intensity, local, national, international, 9 marks, allotted marks, total point 75 marks, faculty appraisal and the promotion policy, as their stated policy in place of the faculty appraisal, maximum marks 9, allotted marks, what is the role of the self-appraisal by faculty in the faculty appraisal, maximum marks 9, allotted marks, what is the practice adopted for the enabling the faculty to pursue research, maximum marks 12, allotted marks, elaborate upon the faculty or retention policy, if any, in the by the B school, 10 marks, allotted marks, total point 40 marks, international linkage process, nature of the student exchange program with national and international B school, 9 marks, allotted marks, nature of the faculty exchange program, 8 marks, allotted marks, foreign student allotment, 3 marks, allotted marks, total point 20 marks, staff appraisal development and the promotion process, are there written policy for the staff appraisal development program, 5 marks, allotted marks, What are the procedure adopted by the institution to implement the standard policy of the fragile process development? 6 marks, allotted marks. What are the measures taken to develop the staff and their qualification? 9 marks, allotted marks, total point 20 marks. Academic results. Elaborate main type of the student and corporate clients served by the B school, 17 marks, allotted marks. The number of the quality of the book published by the faculty, 18 marks, allotted marks. Documentation of the field work by way of the development of cases and audio visual material, if any, 20 marks. Total points, 50 marks, 55 marks. Placement, nature of the key employer for the institution placement, maximum marks, 30, allotted marks. Level of the employment and salary levels of the alumni, 30 marks. Total points, 60 marks. Value and ethnic centric outcome. Does the B schools have a clearly articulated core value system? Maximum marks, 6 marks, allotted marks. If yes, how are the core value in the institution activity? Maximum 6 marks, allotted marks. Have business ethics been integrated into the program design outcomes and personal development of the student? 6 marks, allotted marks. Transparency, accountability in the process and transaction reflected in the B school various persons, 6 marks, allotted marks. Total marks, 25 points. Entrepreneurship and the job creation. If the entrepreneurship skills building designated into the program for the curriculum or not, maximum marks, 4, allotted marks. Evidence of the entrepreneurship activity, 3 marks, allotted marks. Evidence to the contribution to the family business is installed, 3 marks, allotted marks. Total points, 10 marks. Industry interaction, are the stated policy used in industry interaction, 7 marks. Is the overall customer orientation of the B school, 6 marks. Nature of input in the B school activity by the management practitioner with experience from the outside academics, 18 marks. Corporate involvement in the conduct of the institutional activity, 12 marks. And expectation of the parental guardian responsive expectation from the B school activity, 12 marks. Total point, 55 marks. Management development program, revenue percentage of the MDP to the total revenue of the B school, maximum marks, 18 marks, allotted marks. Revenue percentage of the consultancy to the total revenue of the B school, 12 marks, allotted marks. Revenue generated to the from industry research and consultancy project due to the MDP, 6 marks. Total point, 36 marks. International global number of the international exchange program, maximum marks, 6, allotted marks. Number of the international exchange partner, 6, allotted marks. Number of the joint research collaboration with the Indian foreign partner, 12, allotted marks. Total point, 24 marks. Research and innovation, percentage of faculty involved in research and publication, 9 marks, allotted marks. Number of paper published in the referee journal, 21 marks, allotted marks. Total points, 30 marks. Stakeholder satisfaction, way of obtaining student feedback and its use, maximum marks, 8, allotted marks. Wage of obtaining faculty and staff feedback and inputs, 11 marks, allotted marks. Wage of obtaining feedback from industry recruiters and partners and its use, 9 marks. Way of obtaining alumni feedback and its use, 6 marks, allotted marks. Nature of alumni support in the brand building of the B school, 6 marks, allotted marks. Total points, 40 marks. Contribution to the society, the extent to which the B school contributes to the society at the local level, maximum marks, 6, allotted marks. The extent to which the B school contributes to the society at the national level, 6, allotted marks. The extent to which the B school contributes to the society at the international level, 6, allotted marks. Activity which lie outside the normal teaching of research contribution to the mission, 7 marks, allotted marks. Total point, 25 marks. Annexure 4, criteria satisfaction checklist for answers and reviewers, institution, mission, governance and leadership partners. Clarity of the mission, maximum marks, 6, allotted. Effectiveness of the B schools, low, medium and the high. Periodic assessment for the making activity and process consistent with the mission. alignment between the B school culture and operational value, match between the strategic objective and the resources content, effectiveness of the external and internal decision making structure and coherence, review of the B school strategy position every 3 years, the process of innovation and contribution improvement, strategy deployed for the meeting agency, the extent of the involvement of the corporate in the B school main functional characteristics reflected in the mission, logistic of the formal mechanism, collective leadership and its vision, accountability of the decision making, be adopted by the institution to sustain its ownership, compatibility of resources to the aspirants, 20 marks, total point 120 marks, student 8 marks, faculty 5 marks, library, national and global input, quality assurance policy, finance, academic assessment process, placement process, research and development process, leadership and governance, MDP consultancy process and industry interaction, faculty appraisal and promotion policy, international linkage process, staff appraisal and development process, academic results, placement, values and ethnic center outcomes, entrepreneurship and the job creation, industry interaction, management development program, international global links, research and innovation, stakeholder satisfaction, contribution to the society, and this is the NBA office, East Tower, 4th floor, Bishwitama Mark, Pragati, Bihar, New Delhi.